Hi everyone, welcome to Monitor Max channel where we discuss all things machine condition monitoring using the latest technology. Here, we don't just provide technical insights, we also help you advance your career with industry-recognized certifications and practical skills that truly make a difference. Let's talk journal bearings. What are journal bearings? A journal bearing is a type of plane bearing that supports a rotating shaft, allowing it to spin freely within a stationary housing. Unlike rolling element bearings, which use balls or rollers, journal bearings operate based on a sliding motion between the shaft or journal and the bearing surface. These bearings rely on a thin film of lubricant, either oil or grease, to form a hydrodynamic wedge that separates the moving surfaces, minimizing friction and preventing direct metal-to-metal contact. The purpose of journal bearings is multifaceted. First, they support radial loads, meaning they support forces that act perpendicular to the shaft. They also reduce friction by providing a low-friction surface for the shaft to rotate smoothly. Additionally, the large surface area and continuous oil flow help dissipate heat generated during operation. And lastly, they can absorb and dampen vibration better than rolling bearings due to their film-based operation. So where are journal bearings found? Well, journal bearings are commonly found in high-speed, high-load, or continuous-duty rotating equipment such as turbines, whether steam, gas, or hydro, electric motors and generators, centrifugal pumps and compressors, marine propulsion systems like ship shaft bearings, internal combustion engines, including main and connecting rod bearings, and finally gearboxes and reducers in heavy-duty machinery. The journal bearing operates with either boundary, mixed, or hydrodynamic lubrication, depending on speed and load. Hydrodynamic lubrication is ideal. A full film of oil separates the surfaces when the shaft is spinning at sufficient speed. As the shaft rotates, the oil film builds pressure and supports the load, centering the shaft inside the bearing. During startup or shutdown, when the shaft speed is low, the oil film may not fully form. This is called the boundary lubrication condition. Bearings often use a continuous oil supply system for lubrication and cooling. Some systems include oil rings, pressure pumps, or mist lubrication. Let's dive into some general knowledge and design considerations. First up, clearance. A precise gap exists between the journal and the bearing surface. If it's too tight, it may cause metal contact. On the other hand, if it's too loose, it can lead to instability or vibration. Now let's talk about materials. Journal bearings are typically made from soft, conformable materials like Babbitt, also known as white metal, bronze, or composite materials. These materials can embed small particles and avoid shaft damage. Failure modes: oil starvation, contamination, excessive load or misalignment, and overheating or lubricant breakdown. Advantages: quiet operation, long life under proper lubrication, and capable of handling very high loads. Disadvantages: requires continuous lubrication, more complex alignment and installation, and less suitable for low-speed, low-load applications. Conclusion: journal bearings are essential components in many types of industrial and rotating machinery, particularly where high speeds and heavy loads are involved. Their successful operation depends heavily on proper lubrication, precision engineering, and routine monitoring, such as oil analysis or vibration monitoring. Understanding their function and care is vital for machinery reliability and longevity. If you found this video useful, please like, subscribe, share it with friends and colleagues, and visit our website at www.monitormaxengine.com.